Hi, everybody. Still don't know how to do that. Turn on the video from here, but we will make do, won't we? So, hi. I hope you're all well. I hope you had a chance to look at my other chair yoga video. Having mentioned that, if you're new to yoga, new to chair yoga, new to my class, you might want to look at that first video, and you can find it. Let me turn the music down. You can find all of my videos by going to loryyoga.com, which is LoryYoga.com. And then when you come into my webpage, at the top there'll be a heading, and you can see videos. Click on that, and you can choose from the videos that I've posted as of late. We have a yoga nidra. We have the beginner yoga class, although it's not labeled beginner. And then this one. So I thought we could use a break, right? I don't know about you guys, but I'm getting a little bit stir crazy being in the house, or not being able to see our friends, not be able to go to our classes. So I thought with this chair class, we do some a little bit out of the ordinary movements, just to bring some fun into our lives. But pretty much we'll do our usual yoga stuff. Okay, so let's start in nice, comfortable seated position. Feel your sit bones really connected to the chair. Knees in line with the hips. Knees in line with the ankles. Feet are hip width apart. Lengthen the spine and drop the shoulders. Close your eyes. A couple things I didn't mention, and I'll quickly mention them now, is to make sure that your chair is secure. Notice that if your chair is on a slippery surface like hardwood or linoleum, that you might want to put the chair on a rug underneath or on top of the hard surface. We don't want any slipping. We want to feel that we can count on that chair to support us. So come inward and notice, how are you feeling today? Breathing in and breathing out, and just letting go of your day, of your situation, of your concerns for others, and just for this little time that we have together, let all that go and come inward. How do you feel physically? Is it the usual answer, or something new going on? Maybe you laid wrong last night in bed, wrong pillow. Just notice. And then for a moment, just check in and see how you feel emotionally. And I bet you we all feel a lot of the same things emotionally, being isolated from others. So let's connect with the spirit that connects us. So come into your breath. As I'm breathing in, you're breathing in. As I'm breathing out, you're breathing out. Feel the connectedness of it. Your feet are on the earth's surface. So are mine. We're not that far away from each other. Breathe and feel more connected. I truly want to connect with you in this way so that we continue our practice together. It's very important. Let's go into our pranayama, our breathing exercise. Nothing too complicated. We're just going to simply notice the breath as it is right now. Throughout the day, the body adjusts how deeply you should breathe, depending on what you're doing. If you need more oxygen or not. So how are you breathing right now? Without changing anything, just notice how deeply the body has decided you need to breathe. And then begin to deepen your breath a little bit. We just deepen a little at a time, so we slowly increase the volume of air that we take in. And as far as the exhalation goes, we just let it go. Let it passively roll out of the body. A little bit deeper until you find that deep breath that feels comfortable to you today, in this moment. Let go of everything else but the breath. And we'll take two more breaths just like this. Slowly let the body take over the job of breathing for you again. Let go of the control and gently blink open your eyes. Welcome to your practice. Namaste. And for those of us who don't remember or do not understand what namaste means, we use it a lot in yoga. And I've heard that people are starting to use it out and about instead of shaking hands. But what it really means is the goodness in me recognizes the goodness in you, and we bow to that spirit in each other. So namaste. I see you. So it's been a while. I miss y'all. Miss each and every one of you. I miss coming to your area where you take classes, but here we are. We have to be adaptable, right? That's all part of yoga. And as you can see, or maybe not, I'm outside on my side porch. I just noticed I have an elephant just peeking between my legs. That's a little unnerving. Let me move him. There. So he's a sweet little elephant. And you'll see that I have a couple of different elephants, or maybe you can't see, but elephants, especially with a trunk up, are good luck. We need a little bit of good luck, right? So drop your shoulders down. Let your arms just dangle. Shake your head no, shake your head yes. Take a moment and notice, how's the neck feel today? And then we're just going to inhale the arms up. I call these Tai Chi Cha arms because I learned this movement in a Tai Chi Cha class with my friend Teresa, and Michelle was the teacher. So inhale, the wrists come up. Exhale, you just let everything softly come back down. So here, we let all tension out of the body, so bending the elbows, the wrists are soft, the shoulders are soft. Inhaling up, exhaling down, still feeling connection with your feet on the floor, on your block. And then we're gonna do one more. Breathing in, exhaling down. And just bring your hands to your knees, and we'll do our rock and roll. So lift your heels up and then your toes. And you can see today I have shoes on because I'm outside and it's just a little bit chilly. So normally I don't. I usually like to do my yoga in my bare feet. But having said that, you can be in any shoes that you feel comfortable moving in. Just be mindful if you're only wearing socks that when you stand up, that maybe take those socks off or make sure that you're on a rug where you're not gonna slip. Bring your heels up, toes up, one more, heels up, toes up. We'll take that right leg out and in, left leg out and in. Breathe. Just starting to warm up the body. Nothing complicated about our chair yoga classes, but it's really wonderful to continue to move. The body responds so well to movement. I've said a million and one times that every time you move a joint, that joint gets some lubrication, so it's really good. So how about we try to work a little bit on brain? So if we do something, whatever it is, with the lower body, and then something different with the upper body, it makes the brain have to work a little bit harder. We actually laugh a lot when we do this in class, don't we? So we're just gonna let the arms dangle down, keep the feet moving, and roll the shoulders back. First thing you'll notice that you want to stop the feet or the legs, but don't. Keep it moving and keep breathing. Roll the shoulders the other way. Keep your feet moving. Every time we do something different like this, it's called cross body exercise. Every time we do that, we are making new neural pathways in our brain and stop and lengthen the spine and breathe. So I promised you a little bit of fun, right? So I have a prop. I know Lori always has props. So today I have this very unusual, it's a pool noodle. It looks like a pool noodle. That's because it is a pool noodle. But instead of your typical pool noodle, I've got, I don't know if you can see, there's a little bit of a wooden dowel. Not a little bit, there's a wooden dowel in the middle of it to make it firm so that I can lean on it. So you're like, Lori, I don't have a pool noodle with a wooden dowel in the middle of it. I know. I'm sorry. I think that you could find something in your house. So you can pause the video, maybe a broom. But if we use the broom, you're going to want the bottom part down so that you can depend on it. This is too much of a surface. So find your pole, whatever it may be. And we're gonna widen our legs. And the noodle, move the chair a little bit so I'm not having the noodle right in front of my face, but the noodle's between your knees. Lengthen up, drop the shoulders. So you're holding your hands where your shoulders can drop. We'll bring the noodle in, don't wag yourself, and out. Just bend the elbows in and out, breathe. Shoulders want to help all the time, so try to remember, and I'll remind you a lot, to keep the shoulders down. So usually I like to start my yoga classes in torso rotations, so today we're going to rotate our torso, but we're also rotating this noodle or pole or broom or whatever it is that you have, and you'll see it's not ideal. If I had like a yoga mat underneath my pole, probably wouldn't move so much, but go the other way. Pull the navel in, doing torso rotations in a little bit different. So if you don't have a pool, or if you don't have a pole and you don't want to use a pole, you could just do your torso rotations like this. We're adaptable here at LorYoga. One more. Great. And sit up nice and tall. We're going to bring our feet back in line with our knees. It doesn't look like mine are because I'm diagonal a little bit to the camera, but we're going to take the pole in the right hand, bring it forward, and bring it all the way back. Make sure you have room. Bring it forward and back. Shoulders are down. Breathe. Lengthen the spine. Nothing else is changing. I'm going to move my chair because I'm hitting my spa. Forward. Forward and back. Next time we're gonna hold it back here, drop the shoulders. Maybe the hand can go a little more midline. Drop the shoulders, lengthen the spine, soften your jaw. Breathe. Bring it back. We're gonna switch. Here we go. Push it forward, bring it back. Push it forward, bring it back. Push it forward, bring it back. If you feel like your shoulder wants to come up, don't let it. And breathe. Breezy day here in Arizona today. It's probably maybe 60. So it's warmer in the sun. Next one, we're gonna hold back, shoulders down, and you can't see, but I'm bringing my hand into the midline. So So I'm trying to bring it towards the back of the chair. Shoulders down. Engaging your shoulders here and your arm muscles. Really feel your tricep here. One more breath, lengthen the spine. And then bring it back. Good. We're going to hold it. So you're going to need some room. If you have a friend doing yoga with you, you need some space. But we're going to row the boat. Now, I'm just upright right now. So I'm just really working my arms and my shoulders. A little bit of chest, upper back. But what if we put this with the boat pose? Remember, boat pose, let's stop for a moment. Pull the navel and get long. And you want to lean back. So I'm a little bit farther away from the back of my chair. I'm not right here. And we didn't talk an awful lot about position in this video because I wanted to get right to it. But if you're confused about your position in the chair, please watch my first video. So we're going to do boat pose, which is just leaning back towards the chair, but I'm not touching the back of the chair. And we're going to add these rows. Lorelei would call this oaring. I'm not allowed to call this rowing, but I do. Sorry, Lorelei. And then come forward and back. Pull the navel in. Breathe. Bring the hands up above the head, a little bit wider than shoulders, and we're gonna twist to the left, come back, twist to the right. And remember, I never passed that right left test, so just go one way and go the other way. Lengthen the spine. Breathe. One more. One more left, one more right. We'll bring the body straight and lower the arms down. Bring them up. Bend. Press. And down. Bring them up, bend, up, and down. You can widen your arms, up, bend, up, and down. Pull the navel in and make sure you're breathing. Sure hope you're breathing. And up, and press, and down. One, and bend. Two more, two. Last one. Hold it here, lower down, really slow, drop the shoulders. Keep it parallel, shoulders down, look over the right shoulder, look back to center, look over the left shoulder. Good. Bring your pool noodle back on to your legs. We're gonna push a little bit of energy into the leg, so we lift that leg. I'm doing my right leg first, and I'm gonna down, same leg, and down. Don't let your shoulders come up. Creating a little bit of resistance for that right leg, right hip, right quad. One more, and let's reset that, come to a nice seated mountain position. We're going to push down and raise the left, lift it up. And breathe. A couple more. Just think how strong your legs are getting. Just do one more. Good. We'll go back to the right leg. Lift it up, straighten, bend, and lower. Lift left, straighten, bend, and lower. Lift up, straighten, bend, and lower. So it's optional whether you want to put, oops, I can't talk. Lift, straighten. I'm putting a little bit of pressure into the pool noodle. Do as I say, not as I do. Sorry about that. And straighten. Great. And left and right. How about we lift the noodle up? Pull the navel in, drop your shoulders, come chest and press, chest and press. If you've had hip replacement or a knee replacement, we want to make sure we don't lift the knees too high. Breathe. And then we're gonna keep the feet on the floor, lift your arms up, and then just stretch back. You can widen your hands, that'll make the stretching back a little bit easier, but only come until you feel a nice stretch, no pain, right? Lengthen the spine. Breathe. Maybe close your eyes as we're holding this and coming inward, and notice how this feels to the body. Breathe. So we can go from this asana into cat and dog. So we're gonna exhale, bring the pool noodle forward, hollow the belly, arch the back towards the back of the chair, bring the pool noodle down, look down, we're in cat. We'll inhale, bring the arm, the pool noodle up, and then bring your heart forward, tailbone comes up. Just connect with your breath. Exhale. And inhale. And exhale. How does this feel? If I were to answer that question right now, it would be feeling like, oh gosh, I miss you guys, and I miss doing this with you every day. I've been very bad, I hate to admit, but I haven't done yoga every day on my own, just a little bit. It's not as fun without you. One more. Great. And bring your arms all the way down. Bring your hands in, let the shoulders drop. Just sit here and let everything settle. Feel your feet connected to the earth. My feet are connected to the earth. Your feet are connected to the earth. Therefore, we're connected. We're together doing this practice, this beautiful practice for health and relaxation and to get rid of stress. Apparently, this is stress now. Okay, so we're gonna stand up. Now that we have the pool noodle or your pole, you can widen your legs. You can use this instead of your hands, and you're like, I don't think so, Lori. And you put that away and you hold on to your legs. We always hinge forward. The weight stays mostly in the heels. If you put a lot of weight in your toes, you're gonna take a header. Nobody's allowed to do that. That's like my only rule. You can swear at me. You can throw my rubber bands at me, as long as I don't get hit. And lots of other things, but you can't fall. So, shoulders down, pull the navel in. So I'm gonna show you one time what it looks like to do quarter stands with your hands here. So I'm barely getting my bottom off of the chair, but you can also do it with the pool noodle. Be mindful that you're not up here and you're stressing your shoulders and your back out. You have a nice tall spine. Hinge forward, so you might want to move the pool noodle away from you a little bit more. Get good leverage. Pull the navel in. Here we go. One. Oh, by the way, we're doing five. Two. Quarter stands. Three. Four. And then we're going to do five half stands. So you take as much or as little of this as you need. Do you notice I changed my grip? So you might have to move your hands up or down the pole. This is the last one, if I counted correctly, which I wouldn't bet, and then come all the way up. Great, congratulations, you're standing. So if you have some place to put your pool noodle, you can take a moment and fix your clothes asana, right? And stand hip width apart in a beautiful mountain pose. So we have the pool noodle, so we don't necessarily need the chair, but I'm gonna bring the chair in front of us just so you know. You can bring the chair here. Mine's gonna be out to the side. And every time we stand up and sit down, I always ask you to take a drink, so hydrate. It's water with a little bit of tea in it. It's not a margarita, I promise. And come to a nice, tall spine. Breathe. Looking forward, so I'm not looking right at the camera because it's low. So I want you also to look forward straight ahead of you. Breathe. Pull the navel in, drop the shoulders, soften the jaw. So we're gonna grab your pole or your chair. If you have a pole, it's gonna be right in front of you. And the first thing we're gonna do are squats. So widen your feet. And see, people often ask me, when you're doing squats, do you bring your toes out? What feels better? Typically, we don't put our knees out, or toes out, I'm sorry, but if that, not putting your toes out bothers your knees, then I say just move them a little bit. But we are sitting back into our heels and up. So we're gonna do a couple of those. You ready? Lengthen up, drop the shoulders, and squat and up. Just like when you're trying to, or beginning to stand, here, let me go a little bit diagonal. So we are not putting a lot of weight in the toes, settling more of it into our seat, if you will. Two more, one and two. Good. Bring your feet underneath you. Come back into mountain. We're going to huff the pool noodle over to the left, or you're going to hold on to your chair over to the left. We're going to lift the right leg up. Breathe. Drop the shoulders. Whoa. Breathe. So you have this pool noodle. You can lean into it, right? Does this look good, like good posture? No. We want to have a nice tall spine. We don't want to put too much energy into one specific place. See if you can straighten your leg and bend. Straighten and bend. Just two more. Straighten and bend. Straighten and bend. Hold it here. If you want to work a little bit on your balance, pull the navel in, focus your eyes, and I'm going to see if I can pick up this pool noodle or whatever you're having. If you have your hands on your chair, you're just going to let go. If you have the noodle, we're lifting it up and down. Breathe. Three and four. Bring the noodle back down. Bring that foot down. Walk in place. Let's do the other side. You know what we're going to do? We always start in a really good mountain pose. Feel that whatever you're leaning on, whether it's the pole or your chair, that it's secure. So the right leg is now, or this leg, closest to the pole. And I can't do pole or pool noodle. It's getting my mind all crazy. Anyway. You're going to, that's your standing leg, so the knee is slightly bent, and we're going to lift the other leg up. Breathe. Remember our two secrets? Pull the navel in, focus your eyes. Two secrets for balance. Maybe on this side, you're like, there's no way I'm going to let go of that chair or lift that pool noodle, and that's okay. You listen to your body. If you can let go, we're gonna lift this pool noodle up four times. One, two, three, and four. Bring it down. Bring your foot down. Walk. I'm gonna come a little bit closer to you so that you can see how short my pants are really short. So our feet are hip width apart. We're gonna come into some lunges. So take that right leg back. You're like, well, how can I do this with a chair? Stay. Chair is here. And you're gonna take one leg back. The heel goes on the floor, the front knee bends. And remember, that front knee wants to be in line with your ankle and then lengthen up. Once you've looked, you're like, yep, check, 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 lengthen up. So it's chair or the pole. Can't see, but this is what My heel is on the floor. No, that doesn't help. Anyway, my heel is on the floor. Trust me. Lengthen up and breathe. Lengthen. Bend the knee. You want that knee to stay bent. So the tendency is the more we hold it, the more that we start coming up. So yeah, if you have to, you come up. If not, you're gonna stay here, work on some power in those muscles of our legs. Pull the navel in. Breathe. One more breath. You're gonna hold on to the chair or the pole and bring that back foot forward. Mountain. We're gonna switch. Chair or pole, you decide. But the other leg's gonna go back. So the leg closest to the chair, closest to the pole. Check your knee is in line with your ankle. Hips are forward, lengthen up. I'm not bringing my shoulder way up, it's down. Breathe, lengthen. Your heel is on the floor. Feel your muscles engaging and working here. I apologize if I'm not looking at you. I'm not a camera person. I'm used to looking up or looking at people. So one more breath. Use some energy into that pole or into your chair. Bring that leg up. Walk. Switch. Right leg goes back and in and back and in and back and in and back and in and back. This is 5 and 6. Bring it back. Mountain. Now you know we're gonna do 6 on this side, so just take a moment. Breathe. We wanna enter this exercise with a little bit of calmness, right? We don't want to be going, okay, let's go. You want to relax. Here we go. Okay, here we go. Bring it back. 1, 2, 3. You might wonder, is my heel, the back leg, on the floor or off the floor? A little both, to be honest with you. If you have time to put your heel down, go ahead. If not, toes, fine. Last one. Come on up. Walk. Widen your legs. Bring the pool noodle to the left. To the right, left, and right. Circle it. I feel like a cackly witch with her cauldron of soup. Circle this way, people. The other way. So you're like, all right, that's cool, but I don't have a pool noodle. Hula hoops. Or actually, I wasn't really moving my hips. So do some torso rotations. And then we can use the pool. That looked bad. But we're going to do hula hoops. And when you have the pool noodle here, I can't even go there. So if you don't want to use the pool noodle, that's fine. Walk in place. I'm going to set that aside. Just take a deep breath in. And exhale down. Again, in. Exhale down. Roll the shoulders back. Breathe. Mountain, look a right. Look a right. Look a left. Touch your neck. Look right. Don't get dizzy. And then look left. Let's sit down in the chair. What do we get before we sit down? A drink. So if you have a block, awesome. Your block between your legs, lengthen up through the crown of your head. And I'm actually squeezing my knees together, lengthening up through the crown of your head, holding on to the back of the chair or the bottom of the chair. Lift your heels up, squeeze the knees in, lower the heels, toes up. Squeeze the knees. Breathe. Squeeze them in, two, three, and let go. Just take a break here. Take a break. Changing my position for you. We're gonna try that again. Squeeze the inner thighs together. Lift your heels, toes. Heels, toes. Squeeze. It's hard to do all of that at once, right? Making your brain work. You're gonna be smarter. Great, one more. Put your feet down, squeeze. One, two, three, release, let go. We're gonna sit back in the chair, all the way back. Not so far back. This is a pretty good chair. It doesn't let me couch potato, but if your chair's a little bit rounded and you start sliding, gotta get your bottom to the back of that chair. So bring the block in between your knees. You can hold on to your chair or onto your legs. But we're gonna straighten the legs up. Squeeze the inner thighs together. Squeeze, squeeze, lengthen the spine, breathe, squeeze, 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 lower down. Release the block for a minute. Walk in place. Tap, tap. Okay, let's get set up again. Bring the block between your knees. Lengthen up through the crown of your head. Squeeze that block. That's not what we did. We straightened the legs. Squeeze the block. See? You're not here to tell me when I mess up. Squeeze. Squeeze. Breathe. And squeeze. Squeeze. Ah, lower it down. Walk in place. Maybe run in place. We're doing one more. Let it all go. Especially that third time, you tend to anticipate what you're going to do and you get your muscles get tight. So try not to do that. Try to let the muscles relax. Bring the block between your legs, straighten the legs, and squeeze it together. Squeeze, squeeze, lengthen the spine, squeeze, squeeze, let it go. Good job. I'm going to put the block down for a moment and sit back up. We're going to take the right leg out and open, close, and bend. Left and open, left and bend. Work in your hips a little bit more here. Lengthen up. Breathe. What are you thankful for today? I'm thankful for getting it together finally and doing this video and spending some time with you. I'm thankful that the sun is shining. It's really easy to think about what you wish was happening. But let's be thankful for what we have and bring that in and lengthen. Widen your knees. Feel back, feel really solid in the chair. Let's do some regular torso rotations. Breathe. Go the other way. One more. Come up. We're gonna do a nice side stretch. So your hand is on the side of your chair. The opposite arm is up. And we're gonna reach. I'm going left. You can go whichever way calls to you. Breathe. And then release. We're going to the other side. Lengthen up. Nice side stretch. Ooh, feel your ribs opening apart. Breathe. And come back. We're going to do one more each side. Reach up. Get tall on that one side. And then lean in. Breathe. Both of your hips stay solid on the chair. Release. Lengthen the spine. Last one, reach. Breathe. And then come back. Conductor arms. So these are our conductor arms. a really good way to let your shoulders release. Bring your hands back to your knees. Take the right ear to the right shoulder. Your eyes can be closed or downcast. But breathe. Notice where you're holding your shoulders right now. And see if you can drop them. Inhale your head up, left ear to left shoulder. Breathe. Inhale your head up. Shake your head no. Shake your head yes. There goes my pool noodle. A little windy today. Sit back in your chair. So here's where you might want your block underneath your feet. Bring your feet up. Drop your shoulders. Nice tall spine, but relax and supported spine. Close your eyes. So here's the part of our class that I would rub your shoulders. So concentrate on your shoulders right now and see if you can soften them. Together we are strong. That was our mantra for our last class, and I still find that it resonates in my heart. If you agree, you can use that mantra. Together we are strong. Letting go still, connecting with the breath. Warrior mantra, together we are strong. We will get through this together. Together we are strong. Slowly begin to bring yourself back into your physical body. Feel your feet on the block, on the floor, your seat in the chair. Feel the temperature of your skin. Are you warm, cool? And then deepen your breath. Take 3 deep breaths here. And let it out. Again, and let it out. One more, and let it out. We'll end our class today with namaste. So if you want to join me, bring your hands into your heart center, bring your hands together, lengthen up through the crown of your head. Inhale, just exhale. Inhale, namaste. Thank you so much for joining me, my little goofy yoga practice. I hope that you smiled. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope to see you very, very, very soon. I miss and love each and every one of you. Namaste.